Our scripture reading comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Rejoice, people of God, the light has come into the world. O God, now we light the candle of your nativity.
With the company of heaven and with the sounds of great joy, you come to us. This is a time of light and resplendent joy. God has been born among us.
The prophet Isaiah proclaimed a time when those who walked in the shadows would see a great light. A light would shine and a child would be born to us. The evangelist Luke painted the nativity sky and repeated the heavenly song of the angel. Glory, peace on earth, and goodwill. John declared that this great light is Christ, the Word made flesh. This great light lives among us. By it we behold God's glory, full of grace and truth. At Christ's nativity, we now rejoice.
Let us pray. God, our life and light, thank you for coming this night to us. Thanks for touching all heaven and all earth with your splendor. In every corner of the world, shine on us with your peace. In every corner of our hearts, shine on us with your grace. Amen.
Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Thank you. I am Susan Smith, pastor to children and families at Willow Glen United Methodist Church in San Jose, California. And we are so glad you have joined us to celebrate the gift of God's love this evening. Receive this Christmas blessing. Christ is born. Like a child tender in your arms, may the nearness of God warm you. Like the awe of the shepherds, may the love that unites us all enfold you. Like the song of angels, may the promise of our belovedness give you hope. Like the wonder of Mary and Joseph, may God's presence awaken us to our siblings in the poor. Like the radiance of the star over Bethlehem, may the light of God's love shine in you. Give light to those who sit in darkness and the shadow of death, and guide your feet into the way of peace. Christ is born. God is with us. Alleluia. Amen. Thank you.
From the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 11, verses 1 through 10. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And shall make of him quick understanding in the fear of the Lord, and he shall not judge after the sight of his eyes, neither reprove after the hearing of his ears. But with righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity the meek of the earth. And he shall smite the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips shall he slay the wicked. And righteousness shall be the girdle of his loins, and faithfulness the girdle of his reins. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. And the sucking child shall play on the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. And in that day there shall be a root of Jesse, which shall stand for an ensign of the people. To it shall the Gentiles seek, and his rest shall be glorious. The word of the Lord.
This is the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 2. I'll be reading from the New International Version. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinus was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. Glory to you, O Lord.
What child is this?
Our scripture is from the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." The word of the Lord.
Ringing out so sweetly, ringing out so And it came about, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds began saying to one another, "Let us go straight to Bethlehem, then, and see this thing that has happened, that the Lord has made known to us." And they came in haste, and found their way to Mary and Joseph, and the baby, as he lay in the manger. And when they had seen this, they made known the statement which had been told them about the child. And all who heard it wondered at the things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, just as had been told them.
Thank you. A reading from the first chapter of John, verses 1 through 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The world became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
See his star.
Rejoice, God, we sing with the angels to celebrate the tremendous gift of your Son, Jesus. We rejoice with gladness. You give us wonderful joy and peace in our Savior. May we exult in your goodness with the exhilaration of children opening gifts. As we bring our offerings this evening, we ask that our lives would reflect your joy and generosity. Our Christmas offering this year at Willow Glen United Methodist Church will support the ongoing ministries of this congregation and our apportionments, the gifts we make to support the wider ministry of the United Methodist Church. Offerings may be made at wgumc.org/give. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jesus, the light and the life, is born on this night. Each of us carries a piece of that light within us. As you see the light shared this evening, passing from one to another, I hope you will feel yourself brighten with the light of Christ and find ways to share the light with others in the days to come. Now it is Christmas. The Christ child is here. May we mirror his light. May we share his life. May we return his love. May we share his hope. May we live our joyful praise. Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus. Amen. Merry Christmas.